So how was your paper yesterday?
It was good, but it was very lengthy.
It was very lengthy. Maybe because you have left writing.
No, I don't need any.
No, while we are habitual of something, na, so we are able to write it in exam. You should practice writing. What kind of writing do you like? So practice them. Okay, so today we are discussing short story A Face in the Dark by Ruskin Bond. Yes, read it.
A Face in the Dark. Mr. Oliver, an Anglo-Indian teacher, was attending to his school late one night on the outskirts of the hill station of Shimla. From before Kipling's time, the school had begun on English public school lines, and the boys, most of them from wealthy Indian families, wore blazers, caps, and ties. Life magazine in a feature on India had one called The Dawn of the East. Mr. Oliver had been teaching in school for several years. The Shimla Bazaar, with its cinemas and restaurants, was about 3 miles from the school, and Mr. Oliver, a bachelor, usually strolled in the town streets, running after the dark, when he would take a shortcut to the pine forest. When there was a strong wind, the pine trees made sad, eerie sounds that kept most people on the main road. But Mr. Oliver was not a nervous or imaginative man. He carried a torch and it screamed, the batteries were running down. Moved fitfully down the narrow forest path. When its flickering light fell on the figure of a boy who was sitting alone on a rock, Mr. Oliver stopped. Boys were not supposed to be out after dark. What are you doing out there, boy? Asked Mr. Oliver sharply, moving closer to, so that he could recognize his stranger. But even as he approached the boy, Mr. Oliver sensed that something was wrong. The boy appeared to be crying. His head hung down. He held his face in his hands and his body shook convulsively. It was a strange sound of screaming, and Mr. Oliver felt distinctly uneasy. Well, what's the matter? Asked Lars. His anger gave him great concern. What are you crying for? The boy would not answer or reply. His body continued to react with silent sobbing. Come on, boy, he shouldn't be out there in this hour. Help me, look up. The boy looked up. Yes. He took his hands from his face and looked at his teacher. The light of Mr. Oliver's torch fell on the boy's face. If you could call it, he had no eyes. It had no eyes, ears, nose, and mouth. It was just a round, smooth head with a school cap on top of it. And that's where the story should end. But for Mr. Oliver, it did not end there. The torch fell from his empty hand. He turned and scrambled down the path, running blindly through the forest and calling for help. He was still running around towards the school building when he saw a lantern swinging in the middle of the path. Mr. Oliver stumbled up to the watchman, gasping for breath. What is it, Sahib? Asked the watchman. Has there been an accident? Why are you running? I saw something horrible. A boy leaping in the forest and he had no face. No face, Sahib? No eyes, nose, mouth. What do you mean? Do you mean it was like this, Sahib? Asked the watchman and raised a lamp to his own face. The watchman had no eyes, no ears, no features, not even an eye. And that's when the dream blew the lamp out.
Yes. So let us talk about text first. Then we will move on to other things. So what kind of it this story is? What you have understood?
Supernatural
story. Yes. So what are the elements found in supernatural story?
The elements are fear and suspicion.
Fear. Okay. Fear. Yes. Yes. mystery, suspense, and surprise. So where you have found these supernatural elements of supernatural, where you have found in this story?
I'm like in suspense in the second stanza. In the third stanza, it is written that the weather is strong, wind blew, and the tide is getting eerie and it is smiling. And most of the people didn't want to go to the pine forest in the dark.
Yeah, so these kind of words are used here by the writer. That yes, pine trees made sad, eerie sounds, sad pine trees. So words have major role in our in our life. Or okay, so these are the things: eerie sounds, what are eerie sounds?
Frightening.
That kept eerie sounds that kept most people to the main road. So they were the winds were creating that making those noises. Okay, sometimes in winters also. Okay, you can see that week ago that there was so much wind, and I was feeling like I was awakened at night. And what happened? That some wind came, and I was thinking that someone is outside my room, and I thought that someone, and no one was there. So these kinds of words are used, and they are creating mystery and suspense in the. So these are also creating supernatural element, adding supernatural elements. But Mr. Oliver was not a nervous and imaginative man. So he was a man. He was a kind of man that he doesn't believe in. He didn't believe in those things, supernaturals and all. So, and what we were talking, the dark. Dark. So where they have talked about that they have used this scene of and yes, so they have used the scene of night here. Okay, and even it's not dark, they create darkness through their words also. Okay, looking fine, that it's a common day and it's a common situation. He was in the market, and in the earlier paragraphs also, that he was just returning to his school. Okay, and then visited which place? Market, and returning again in the night. So he was he doesn't believe in these kind of supernatural things. So what happened in the last after when he was returning school.
When he was returning, then the light from his torch fell on a boy, and he was sitting on a rock alone, and he seemed like something was wrong. Then he went closer. He said, he thought something, maybe the boy is crying, but it was very strange and sound was speaking. Maybe there was no sound of his crying. So he got it. He felt very uneasy. Then he asked the boy to raise his head. Then the boy rose his head, and he thought the boy had no eyes, no eyes. He was very surprised and shocked by that face of the boy. Then he had to run. The torch fell from his hand, and then he was running towards the school building. Then he saw a lantern sitting in the path, and he was the watchman. The watchman was holding the lantern. Then he said, the watchman asked him that what happened. Has there been an accident? Then he said, yes, I saw a very burning boy. He was leaving the forest, and he had no physical injuries. Then he said, let's go to the lantern. Then he goes to the lantern to do what he said. Then the watchman said,
yes, very nice, mashallah. So, what are you doing out here, boy? So, when he met this boy, what are you doing here, boy? Doing out here, boy? Asked Mr. Oliver sharply, moving closer to, so that he could recognize the miscreant. But even so, here you can find the element of suspense. Okay? In this paragraph. And as he approached the boy, Mr. Oliver, yes, what happened? Mr. Oliver, but even as he approached the boy, Mr. Oliver sensed that something was wrong. The boy appeared to be crying. His head hung down. He held his face in his hand. So up till now, it is considered that he is a boy, and his body shook convulsively. It was a strange, soundless weeping, and Mr. Oliver felt distinctly uneasy. So he is receiving an energy, okay, that kind of negative energy here. So whenever something bad happens, sometimes we feel that bad energy, okay? It is said that birds and animals can also feel that energy. They receive this energy. So in earthquakes and all these mishaps, what happened? They feel it before human beings. So do you feel that energy transfers from one human being to another? Human beings to human being? Yes? No? Yes. Transfers. We cannot see, but we can feel it. Our senses, or like if I am happy, okay, if I am happy now, and I'm smiling towards all people, so what happened? I spread this kind of energy. Or if I will be sad, or I will be feeling another kind of feeling, so this will also spread. So this is called energy. Okay, so here he has felt that something is wrong with this boy. So he was feeling uneasy, distinctly uneasy. Mr. Oliver felt distinctly uneasy. You should have brought your book, but it's okay. So what happened after this? read it. The portion after this. Mr. Oliver felt distinctly uneasy.
When was the matter this entity to concern? What are you trying for? The boy was not answered on his body. His body is that silent for it. And what boy is out here for this rat, this article? Look up. The boy looked up to his he took his hands from his face and looked up at his teacher. The light from his followers' thoughts fell on the boy's face. You could call it a
face. Yeah. Okay. Sit down. Thank you. Mr. Oliver, it did not end here. The torch tail from his trembling hand. So he is frightened and feeling terrible. He turned and scrambled down the path, rushing towards the main road. So now this kind of faith that belief that he doesn't believe in imagination, he doesn't have that kind of imagination and believe that there is nothing like supernatural. So now it is this idea is shattered. Okay, this idea of Mr. Oliver shattered here. The torch fell from his trembling hand. He turned and scrambled down the path, running blindly through the trees and calling for help. He was still running towards the school building. When he saw a lantern swinging in the middle of the path, Mr. Oliver stumbled up to the watchman, gasping for breath. "What's it? What is it, Sahab?" Sahib asked the watchman. "Hey, has there been an accident?" "So that he has seen some person, okay, and it was night, so he is carrying a lantern. This person is the watchman, okay. So it usually happens that when he saw a lantern swinging in the middle of the path, Mr. Oliver stumbled up to the watchman, gasping for breath. What is it, Sahib?" asked the watchman. "Has there been an accident? Why are you running?" So this person is considered as the watchman. But what happened? It was opposite of that. "I saw something horrible, a boy weeping in the forest, and he had no face." "No face, Sahib? No eyes, no face. No eyes, face, mouth, nothing. Do you mean it was like this?" "Sahib," asked the watchman. And now he has observed that it. So he looked at the watchman's face and raised the lamp to his own face. The watchman had no eyes, no ears, no features at all, not even an eyebrow. And that is when the wind blew the lamp out. Okay, so what happened? Yes, tell us. Something new you have found in this paragraph? Yes. And what are the other things? Yes, so these kind of words here, you can find imageries, so many imageries are here, okay? So it is considered that you can find it as a supernatural story, but writer makes the supernatural look natural by his artistic skills. So he has written it in that manner that it's the reader could find it natural, but it's not a common story, but a supernatural story. A face in the dark. So it was a face in the dark, and then he realized that when he raised the lantern, he found that it was not a face, and it was in the dark. So the dark word is used. All these things are secret. Okay, we can use this secret. What are the themes in this story? And what is the style of writing? Simple. Yes. So what kind of narration is used in this?
Third person.
Yes, third person. Third person narration. And what are the other things? So it's said in straightforward manner. Narrated in a yes. So, what are the things you have found? What other things you have found? When you started reading this, so what you have been feeling? So it was strange. It was represented as the atmosphere was strange to you, no? Earlier, it was, no one knew that it could happen, and it suddenly happened. So there was an atmosphere of this atmosphere of strangeness in the story. Yes, in verse 3. Yes, let me see the book. So first, in the first stanza, they were talking about writer is talking about his background, teacher's background, that he was an he is an Anglo-Indian teacher returning to his school. Yes, yes, also about teacher, that he is an Anglo-Indian teacher. This is also an question in your workbook, that how we can say that he is in Mr. Oliver, an Anglo-Indian teacher, how he was an Anglo-Indian teacher. So how he is represented as an Anglo-Indian teacher. And then in the second stanza, you find that he is in bazaar market, Shimla bazaar. So all these things are strange. This kind of have you seen that kind of person? So is it common? Is it normal that a person doesn't have eyes? So how will he will have senses? So these are the five senses, how we can feel without it, how we can survive. So it's not normal. Okay, so this is why it's creating these kind of situations in the story, creating an atmosphere of strangeness. So these incidents you can discuss in your answers. Okay, if you are talking, if you are questioned about atmosphere of strangeness. Yes. Yes, thank you. We will discuss some questions also. So bring out the element of mystery and suspense in the story, Face in the Dark. Bring out the element of mystery and suspense. Yes, we surely discuss these events. That is how we discuss these things in this in our answers. We have to mention it. Description of forest also. Okay, there will come that strong wind was blowing, and pine trees made sad, eerie sounds that kept most people. So when he was passing through the forest, what kind of atmosphere it was? That there was a strong wind, the pine trees made sad, eerie sounds that kept most people to the main road. But Mr. Oliver was not a nervous or imaginative man. So he doesn't believe in those kind of imagination, dark imaginations. You must have seen in the stories also that when something bad happens, that some people believe in good and bad omens. Good and bad omens. So there the batteries were running down and all bad things happening. So these are considered in the society, people believe in these kind of omens, that the batteries, so these pine trees made sad sounds were coming, bad sounds, frightening sounds were coming, and it was getting dark, and receiving that kind of energy, frightful and negative.